A very good morning to my RRA friends. I am Umesh Gyanani, proud member of National Association of Realtors and Chairman Education Committee, RERA Realtors Association, Rajasthan. As I had promised in my last general body meeting of RRA that I'll come up with research-based contents for my RRA friends. So here I am with my first video exclusively for my realtor friends. Few days back, I got a WhatsApp message from Ms. Swati Bejal. She's Secretary RRA, and I read that some Delhi-based real estate brokerage firm has filed corporate insolvency initiative against a Delhi-based builder for non-payment of its due brokerage, and NCLT, National Company Law Tribunal, has initiated corporate insolvency resolution process against Delhi-based builder under Section 9 of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code 2016. Now, prima facie, it seems a normal news, but later on when I started reading between the lines, I realized there are multiple learnings for real estate brokerage firms in this judgment. So, next 2 to 3 minutes, I'll try to explain as a professional realtor what we can learn from this case and how we can ask builders to clear our due brokerage in legal manner. One thing we should know that as per new NCLT laws, for initiation of corporate insolvency, minimum amount of default shall be rupees 1 lakh only. So first learning is that even if your due brokerage is only 1 lakh rupees, you can go to NCLT for corporate insolvency against that builder. I am not asking you to do that. So before moving to NCLT, there are few important things you need to ensure. In this case, the first question was, does brokerage services come under operational debt of the builder company or not? That means if brokerage services are not part of the operational debt, then defaulter cannot be considered for insolvency. But here is a good news for all the realtor friends that real estate brokerage services comes under the operational debt under section 5 inverted comma 21 of the code. So the case was considered for hearing. Now while reading between the lines, in this case, builder challenged the broker on amount payable to broker. But builder failed when broker had shown that due amount was acknowledged by builder office. Point to learn is that whatever is receivable as brokerage to you on each case shall be documented, and this shall be in addition to the standard fee letter you sign with the builder before starting the work. Friends, if you refer to my video on YouTube dated 20th of December 2019 with topic, क्या RERA अथॉरिटी या RERA एक्ट मुझे बिल्डर से मेरी ड्यू ब्रोकरेज दिलाने में मदद कर सकता है? I had clearly mentioned that RERA अथॉरिटी और RERA एक्ट cannot guarantee you for your due brokerage from builder. But if you have proper agreement or fee letter with the builder signed before starting the brokerage work, and if you ensure to put your company seal and signature on each booking form submitted to builder office, plus take proper acknowledgement of each booking with brokerage receivable, then you have a better chance to go to any association or court of law to recover your due brokerage. I have shared details of what all documentation you should do with builder office at different stages of the deal closure in my video dated 20th of December 2009, as I mentioned earlier in this video. Please feel free to write to me gyanani_umesh@yahoo.com for any support on documentation part. It is available for all my realtor friends. So my advice to all my realtor friends, please ensure proper documentation of the deal closed by you or your team, and take proper acknowledgement of the brokerage receivable on each case. I hope you enjoyed this video. As committed, I'll come up with a new case study very shortly. Till then, happy selling.